Get ready to match the stars. Robert Vaughn. Brett Summers. McLean Stevenson. Nancy DeSoto. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
I don't believe it. I'm a player.
How's it going, Gene?
I know you had a little short of wardrobe this week.
I tell you, the guys got tired of lending me stuff. Bob said, absolutely no more. This is it. Dickie said, forget it. The white tie was it. Now, this is it for me, folks. I got the
And I don't want my dress all sweated up.
Well, you put the jacket on him there. I'll do the shirt, my shirt's shoulder, and my shirt's well, I can't even talk.
Okay, I don't want to get it sweaty. Excuse me.
Can we get this?
Fits pretty good.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Okay. Dayton Anderson, would you bring me another jacket from the dressing room, please, wherever you are? Hurry.
Gene.
Yes.
Well, we got to move on. I got to get him over to the Largo.
Okay. let's welcome our two players, shall we? Ellen Hoey and Charlene Jameson. Charlene has won $1,200. How about that?
It's terrific.
That is terrific. And Ellen is challenging her. We finished round one, didn't we? And you just throw it on the set here. Oh, that's it. Just throw it over here. No, don't, not on the floor.
Gene?
You never learned how to throw
Gene,
a jacket, did you?
Listen, could I wear that one? This one's a little itchy, man.
All right, but it's
kind of a woolly.
It's too itchy for you. Okay. All right, just slip that one out.
Talk about no shame. Boy,
you really do get them sweaty, don't you? Okay.
Goes better with a tie.
Goes better with a tie, yes.
As if he'd know.
And as I was saying, Ellen was challenging Charlene and seems to be doing well. 4-2 at the end of round one. And ladies, we'll start round two right after we give these messages to you. All right, here we go, ladies. I'll push the button. And we'll reveal the questions and ask our challenger, Ellen, to make a selection.
B.
B is what she wants. Last time out, you matched four celebrities. Oh. Now you'll be trying to match the other two. They are Robert and McLean.
Yeah, frickin' frick. Dummy in no clothes.
All right, gentlemen, this is it. After his historic ride, Paul Revere said, "Boy, is my blank tired." Paul Revere said that. Did you hear that, Ellen?
Not quite.
I will repeat it for your benefit. After his historic ride, Paul Revere said, "Boy, is my blank tired." No pictures, McLean. Just simple statement, a declarative fact.
He's worried about spelling.
Here we go. Now, they're finished, Ellen. It's up to you to give us your response now. Paul Revere said, "Boy, is my..."
Fanny tired.
Fanny tired, is what she said. Dealing with Robert and McLean, that's what she says. What did you say?
I'd say it's the same thing.
That's it. He says, "But, Fanny, that's one match for you, Ellen." And McLean?
Looks like... Old Dodo Bird and Ding Dong.
Yeah, there it is. Another match. So your work is cut out for you, Charlene. You must match the remaining celebrities. You matched Nancy and Richard the first round. This round, you've got to match the other four. All of them. Here we go. Once upon a time, there was a pigeon who was so rich, he had his own blank.
His own what?
First, I'm best.
His own blank.
Oh. Once
Once upon a time, there was a pigeon.
And he had his own.
Who was so rich, he had his own blank. Oh, yes, you, Robert. You, Brent, and McLean.
Oh.
Everyone but Nancy and Richard.
Dumb birds. Richard. Yeah.
We're perfect.
I'm going to ring the secretary.
Does anybody know where Goodwill is?
Yes, I do. And I'm going to take you there because I know you could do an improvement.
Okay, now, Charlene, once upon a time there was a pigeon who was so rich, he had his own...
apartment.
Apartment. All right. One miss, and the game is over. Robert.
Well, it is a pigeon's apartment. It's a coop.
A coop. Does that match? Yes, it does. Okay. There's one match, Brett.
I'm not sure whether this matches or not, but I assume it does. His own General Grant, too.
Not a match. So Ellen Hoey is the winner. Congratulations. Could you come around, please? Okay, Ellen, right here. $100 for you, and stand by for a moment. We've got to have a word or two with Charlene, who will be leaving us now. But she'll be richer by $1,200.
Thank you
very much, Charlene.
Thank you.
Hope you enjoyed it. Bye. There goes Charlene. That's enough waving. Yeah, that's... Okay. Now, you know how this goes, don't you?
Yep.
You ready for it?
Yep.
Okay. We polled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Broad blank. Broad blank. Broad blank. I don't know how you want to accent it or pronounce it. Now, the answer that audience gave most often is worth $500 to you, Ellen, if you can match it. The second most frequent response, $250, and the third, $100. You're allowed a little help from the celebrities, so choose one at a time and see what you can do.
Betty? It's fine just the way it is. Broadway, I think.
Broadway. Broadway. There's one answer. Another one?
Well, I'm kind of scared of McLean, but I'll try.
McLean.
You're right to be scared.
You don't have to be afraid of me, honey.
I said broad... You said Broadway? I said broad jump. Those people are vicious.
No, they're just 40 broad jumpers in the audience there. Competed in the Olympics. One more.
Robert.
I said both of them, but I'll have to change my mind. Broadside.
Broadside, he says. So you've got Broadway, broad jump, and broadside. You may give us one of those as your answer, or think up another one. What would you like to do?
Broadway.
Broadway is the answer she chooses, the one that Betty White gave you. Let's find out where it is, shall we? We're looking for Broadway. May we see the $100 response? Broad-minded is a pretty good answer that nobody thought of, I think. Okay. Still looking for Broadway. Here is the $250 response. Broad jump is up there. That's the one that's the McLean's answer. Okay. Third and last chance now, Ellen, to look for Broadway. Here is the $500 response. Broadway, you've got it. All right, Betty, well done. You know, Ellen, you've got... You're up to $600. You just won the $500 here. That means you play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Now, to collect, you have to have a head-to-head match with one celebrity, and it must be an exact match. Please choose one now.
Stick with my winner, Betty.
Going to stick with the winner, Betty, she says. All right, Betty, get ready to write. Ellen faces me. Here is the $5,000 question. Whipped blank. All right, did the dinger sound? But she's ready anyway. Betty has finished her answer, and there's the dinger, and now we ask for your response here. Whipped blank, Ellen.
Cream.
Cream is her answer. Cream seems to be the popular answer to the audience for $5,000. Betty, what have you got?
Whipped cream. Whipped cream.
Yes,
back up there. Get back up there. You haven't got any clothes on and you're kissing them.
Well, how do you feel?
Oh, just fine.
Are you excited?
Yeah.
Well, I guess you should be because you're up to...
Oh,
well,
dear.
You better hang on to something here. She's really trembling. You've got $5,600 and you're going to play another game in a minute or two. We'll give you a chance to rest while you read these messages. All right, we're ready to start a brand new game and we've got a brand new challenger here. Let's welcome Mr. Steve Nave. Hi, Steve.
Hi. How are
you? You know Ellen?
Yes.
Steve, tell the folks around here a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm studying acting. I want to be an actor. And I also take real estate in case it doesn't pan out.
You take real estate?
Yes.
Who do you take it from?
Anybody I can.
All right.
It's called us.
Is that all you have to say about
yourself? That's about it.
That's it.
Pretty boring guy.
Okay. Good luck to you, Steve. Now, we'll begin by pushing the button, revealing two questions here, and you make a selection.
I'll take B.
He wants B. New game, folks.
Okay.
Barbara went to the zoo and was blanked by a gorilla. You hit my bursitis.
Oh, oops, I'm sorry.
You hit it for me?
Barbara went to the zoo and was blanked by a gorilla.
I'm coming.
All right, I won't watch if you'll
live. It makes me so nervous.
Okay, I'll stand over here while you're writing.
Well, that's McLean. That makes me nervous.
Oh, all right. Now, everybody's ready, so Steve, we call on you. Barbara went to the zoo and was...
I was going to say raped, but I'm going to say grabbed.
Grabbed by a gorilla.
Yes.
Barbara was grabbed by a gorilla. It's difficult, you know, behind the glass and through the bars and all that, but that's what he says there. What do you
say? Well, if she was grabbed, then she must have been...
Scared.
Scared.
Scared by a gorilla.
No good.
Okay. Brett, what did you say? What about Barbara?
She was chased and caught and had the best time of her life.
Okay, McLean.
I'm going to get a... But I said kissed.
Kissed by a gorilla. There it is.
I hate that person that does that.
Yes.
No, you don't.
You just hate the sound. He's not a bad person.
He's a nice person?
Yes, he's a nice
person. No, he's not a nice person, but he's not a bad person.
Well, that's Iris Kutch, a producer, who does that.
Oh, he's a great guy.
Yeah, he's a great guy. He's a rotten sound, but that's the way it is.
By a gorilla?
Yeah, no, you never. Nancy, what did you say?
I said...
Is his answer.
I said... Hugged.
Hugged and grabbed. How about that, Judge? There's a match. So you score once with that. What about you, sir?
Two hugs.
Another hug.
Al Grabo.
That's enough of that. Oh.
That's protecting her from the gorilla.
Okay. Betty White.
I'll take the gorilla. Listen, if you ain't tried it, don't knock it. I said mugged.
Mugged. No, mugged is...
Oh, mugged.
No,
mugged.
No.
Grabbed,
that's different
mugged.
From grabbing and hugging and all Excuse that, me. Sir. So that's two for you, Steve, and let's see what we've got for Ellen here. When Rodney refused to pay the gypsy fortune teller, she screamed, "May a hornet fly into your blank." You remember Rodney?
Yeah.
You don't remember Rodney?
No.
Refused to pay the gypsy fortune teller. And she said, "May a hornet fly into your blank."
Oh, she said it or he said it?
No, she said it.
She said it.
Honestly, it's not easy up here, Gene.
I'm sorry, Gene.
Hardly seems possible. We've only been at sea 3 days.
All right, Ellen, how do you respond to this? When Rodney refused to pay the gypsy the fortune teller, she screamed, "May a hornet fly into your...
jockey shorts."
No wonder she won $5,600. Okay, she said jockey shorts.
Well, fortunately, Dirty Ellen and I think alike.
Drawers! There's a match! Well, I'll be done. What do you say, Brett?
I think Ellen is deranged, and I think Robert Vaughn is dumb. Underwear!
That's another match! Join the club!
I'll tell you what I think of Ellen. That's what I think of her.
Jockey shorts!
Jockey shorts!
Right on the nose.
I came right out with it.
Nancy, right, are you going to keep it going here?
Oh, real close. Nose.
May a hornet fly into your nose.
Yeah.
That would sting. That would hurt.
Smart.
How about you, sir?
Well, that's the only way, unless they pull the jockey shorts up here. Al Nozo.
Yeah. All right. Betty White, jockey shorts is the answer we're looking for.
Do you sometimes wonder what you're doing here? Jockey shorts.
Yeah. So at the end of round one, it's 4-2 in favor of the champ. We'll start round two right after we pass these messages along to you. Now we're ready to go on here with this game, in which our current champion is ahead, 4-2. We'll start round two by asking Steve to make a decision here.
I think I'll go for A.
You go for A.
Yeah.
All right. Steve, the aspiring actor, wanted A, and this is what he got. The tourist at Mount Rushmore said, "Look at that. George Washington's nose is blank."
I don't write.
You don't write? He doesn't write. You're the only two. The others all write.
We're the best.
You matched the first round, so therefore you will not participate in the second round.
Does that mean we're not the best?
You're the best.
Thank you. Yeah.
The tourist at Mount Rushmore said, "Look at that. George Washington's nose is..." Hold on now. Now, Brett's
right.
Already, so we'll call on Steve for his response. The tourist at Mount Rushmore said, "Look at that, George Washington's nose is..."
Cracked, like my voice.
Cracked. He said his nose is cracked.
Mm. He is a good actor.
Cracked his voice.
Well, what did he say?
Cracked.
Cracked?
Okay. Cracked. That's what he
possibly
I want to keep with the smut thing. It's dirty.
George Washington's nose is dirty. There. Okay, Brett.
George Washington's nose is covered with pigeon droppings.
Now.
Is that wrong? That's right.
I don't know if there are any pigeons around Mount Rushmore, but that's
why not? They're everywhere.
Steve, you must match the two remaining celebrities, McLean and Betty, in order to stay in the game. Let's see if it happens. Cracked is his answer, McLean.
Good. Mine's running.
Running. So, welcome to the game. Congratulations. Can you come down, please? Getting to be a familiar spot for you, isn't it? Okay, Steve, we're going to say goodbye to you. We have enjoyed meeting you, and thank you for joining us here on Match Game 73, a gift for Steve Nave backstage. Goodbye, Steve. You know how this goes, so let's fiddle around. You know, let's get right to it, right?
All right.
All right. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank drum. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you can match it, $250 and $100. And a little help from the celebrities, if you please.
Betty.
Oh, Betty White.
Sweetie.
Blank drum.
Bass drum.
Bass drum is what she says.
Richard.
Richard Dawson.
Ear drum.
Ear drum.
Pardon?
Ear drum is your answer.
Robert.
Hum.
Hum drum, he says.
Nice.
Hum drum. So you got bass drum, ear drum, and hum drum. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. But now we have to call for an answer, Ellen. Which one will it be?
Bass drum.
You say bass drum. You think she's right? You're going to find out right now. Here we go. We're looking for bass drum. May we see the $100 response? Hum drum. That was his answer. That was Robert Vaughn's answer. Okay. Now, we're still looking for bass drum. May we see the $250 response? Ear drum is up there, the one that Richard Dawson gave you.
Pardon?
Last chance for bass drum. Here is the $500 response. Bass drum is up there! Congratulations. Okay, so she's got the $500, and you've got this message, and then you hurry right back.
Don't we make a lovely couple?
Gorgeous.
We got caught on stage together, so we're just going to stand here together and say goodbye together. Listen, next time we get together, you're going to have a goal at over $5,000. So you'll come back next time. And we will look forward to seeing all of your bodies sometime in the very near future.
Well, see your body now.
That's enough.
I liked him better in
his
jacket.
We'll see you on MASH, and you here, and you there, and we'll see all of you one place or another. That's it.
Where?
And Betty White, you're on the Mary Tyler Moore Show coming up very soon, right?
Third one. Yes.
Your third one.
Third one.
Gee, that's terrific. And she's very terrific on it. And you're terrific, and I love your cuffs.
Well, thank you.
Ring for service, the sign says. Okay, we will.
Just a small
now,
bar
listen,
I have.
If you'll all tune in next time, we're going to have this galaxy of stars.
Robert Q. Lewis, Brett Summers, Maury Amsterdam, Joyce Boulafont, Richard Dawson, and Ann Elder.
Gene Rayburn saying so long for Match Game 73. Join us next time.
Today's consolation prizes are from Montgomery Ward's Christmas Catalog. A remote control wireless clock radio operates lights, TV, or coffee pot automatically from the Montgomery Ward Catalog. And California Dried Figs, one of nature's best sources of vitamins, minerals, and quick energy fruit sugar. Naturally good to eat and nutritious California Dried Figs. And Rice-A-Roni, the big flavor side dish. So quick, so easy, saute and simmer to flavor perfection. Rice-A-Roni, the San Francisco treat. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Ha, ha, ha.